Hi, it's Giffen Lebates here, and another day, another DeFi disaster. And today's disaster comes courtesy of the Compound protocol. And Compound is a lending and borrowing DeFi application that allows people who have a bunch of tokens that they have no use for to deposit them with Compound and earn interest on them. And similarly, it allows people who need some tokens for a period of time to avoid the inconvenience of having to go to an exchange and buy them and then go back to the exchange and sell them. Instead, they can borrow them from Compound and then pay them back with interest. And most of that interest then goes to the lenders. So the disaster is that Compound paid out $90 million worth of tokens to people who hadn't earned that interest. So what they've done is they've overpaid interest, and they've overpaid it because of a simple bug on one line. Now, there are about 4,566 lines of code in the part of the protocol where this error occurred. And the error is a single equal sign missing in a comparison. And actually, that error has been there all the way from the start, but it got triggered now because Compound upgraded their controller.sol module. So they upgraded a part of the system and they changed a piece of data somewhere else. And that meant that the bug that had been there all along, but actually wasn't significant, suddenly became significant to the tune of $90 million. And just as we had with the Polygon hack, unfortunately, it looks like Compound wasn't prepared for a financial disaster. They didn't have a PR plan in place. And in fact, they went out and told people, please, can you return the money that we have sent you accidentally? And if you don't, we will dox you to the IRS, which for those of you not in the know or not au fait with current slang means we will submit your identity to the American Inland Revenue Service. So a weird mix there of begging and threatening. And begging and threatening is not really a good approach to get people on your side. So just a little side note here, if you're running a DeFi protocol that is holding vast sums of money, for goodness sakes, take the time to have an action plan in place in case something goes wrong. It's the same as hotels having a fire exit route clearly marked. You don't want to wake up in the middle of the night in a room filled with smoke and not have a clue where you're going to run to. That doesn't lead to good decisions. Whereas if you have an action plan in place, then you can follow that and it can kind of get rid of some of the nervous mistakes that will be made if you're just winging it. But anyway, that aside, now I thought I'd move on to an analogy of what went wrong so that those of you who don't know how to read Solidity code can actually understand what happened. And I'm going to use the analogy of a bank. So you can think of Compound as a bank where people can deposit money to earn interest and people can withdraw money in order to, or rather can borrow money for whatever purposes and then have to pay it back with interest. So, and let's say this bank started on January 1st, 2000. And people open accounts and they put money in it and they expect to earn interest and they expect to earn it on a daily basis. So you need to calculate from the point that they deposited the money till now, how long has that money been in there? How much is there? What's the interest rate? Therefore, what should their payments be? And what Compound did was it sort of said, we are this bank and our starting date is this date and we'll call that date zero. And then we'll calculate interest rates from then onwards. And the equality check was to make sure that people hadn't deposited the money significantly earlier and therefore should have had extra payments for the extra time that their money had been sitting in the account. Then what Compound did is they upgraded their software and they changed the start date from zero to another number some point in the future. In this case, I think it was like 7,726 or something like that. And what this did was people who hadn't had tokens locked in the deposit contract, i.e. hadn't invested their money in Compound for a much, much earlier date, were nevertheless being calculated as being owed interest as though it was for that whole long earlier period. So it's like you putting $100 in a bank account today, expecting to earn a small amount of interest daily from now on, and the bank accidentally thinking that you deposited it, you know, 50 years ago and calculating the amount of interest that you should earn that way and then allowing you to online automatically extract it. So that's the mistake. They miscalculate how long people had their tokens locked up in the contract and offered them the right to claim the interest that they shouldn't have earned because they hadn't locked their tokens up that long. So that's the analogy. Now, Compound pretty quickly turned off the web interface that allowed people to go and claim these tokens. But of course, it's a smart contract. Just because the web interface is gone and your average dApp user now can no longer access the functionality of the smart contract that it's providing an interface to, that doesn't stop people from using Etherscan or Remix or even just Hardhat or something from the command line to send the required commands in order to withdraw the tokens to their wallets. And presumably a large number of people did. So anyway, what remains to be seen is firstly, how are Compound going to move on from this? Are we actually going to see a coordinated, sensible, rational campaign to try to remedy the situation? Fortunately, Compound has billions locked up, so 90 million percentage-wise is actually not a huge disaster, and they're lucky that it's capped at that because the account that pays the interest only had that amount in it, so they could put a hold on that. They have a second problem, which is it's a decentralized governance system, so it'll take 6 or 7 days before the request to change this software again to fix the bug can actually go through. So in the meantime, the bug is still there, but all the money's gone from the controller's account anyway, so no more can be taken. And the third one will be to see how many people actually give the money back. Did the strategy of begging and threatening at the same time actually work? I guess we can't really know because we can't do an A-B test and start a parallel universe where Compound didn't both plead and threaten with their users. But in any case, it'll be interesting to follow the media for the next few days and see how much is returned. They've said that people who return it can keep 10% as a white hat fee, which I suppose is an attempt to put a spin on it as well. Anyway, that's today's video. It's gone on a bit longer than I intended to, but this is actually quite a complicated concept. It's also another interesting learning experience for the decentralized finance world. I wonder what the next disaster is going to be. See you in the next video soon. Bye for now.